today, we're testing ourselves in the wind tunnel.
Let's hit it.
Well, that doesn't mess around. That's a full 45 right there.
Why don't we start testing some elements?
Look at that liquid.
I brought my own balloon.
It's a condom.
That is the stupidest thing I've ever recorded in slow motion in my life.
That was a beastly wind tunnel.
It really was. It was, what, 80 miles an hour?
Yeah. The shots of you in the water, especially because we backlit the water, it just looked really cool. Like, it was fascinating to see how the air was moving around you, but it also just looked wicked. It was like commercial-grade footage.
You look like a certain singer from a 90s music video.
Oh, it's magic. I also think that you condom sailing on a skateboard might be the most bizarre thing we've ever shot.
Do you know, that will be one of the most fun things I've done this year, for sure.
Something about your flat hair with your smug face with that flapping in the wind.
Goodness gracious me.
I didn't expect it to work, and then it worked, and I was so happy. It was so much fun.
Well, we thought it'd be a good idea to learn a little bit more about the facility, so we talked to a bloke who works there called Kevin.
Let's kick it to Kev.
Kevin.
Hi, Dan.
Hey, so you're one of the aerodynamicists at Myra, right? Have I got that right?
That's right, yeah.
It's a cool job title.
Damn good occupation.
So what does it actually mean? Like, what do you do?
So one of the jobs I have here is to essentially characterise how vehicles behave from an aerodynamic point of view in terms of drag, lift, front lift, rear lift.
So what are some of the fastest speeds of wind you've seen in this tunnel?
So we usually operate up to about 80 miles an hour.
And that's like equivalent to like a hurricane or something? Light hurricane?
Yeah, a light hurricane.
A breezy hurricane.
They can go quite strong.
So how do you feel about the fact that you're an aerodynamicist with a PhD and does very scientific things, and we come along, whip out a condom and fly along the floor with a skateboard? You're with this huge like scientific facility. You know, do you mind? Is that...
Well, from an engineer's point of view, I kind of have to be very professional about everything, and that basically makes my day job a little bit dry. So to have something interesting happening for once makes quite a nice change. So,
and I bet in the, what, 70, 60-year history of this place?
Yep.
Probably not been done before that.
You may very well have set a record there.
Yes. It's quite an honour that you let us in here, to be honest.
That is great.
Thanks very much, Kevin, for letting us mess around in here.
No, thank you.
It's a real honour.
Thanks a lot. That was really so much fun.
It was a lot of fun.
Glad you had fun.
All right, back to you, Gav and Dan.
Oh, thanks, us. It's amazing how many of the things we filmed are so heavily influenced by aerodynamics.
It's not just things we filmed, though. I remember I used to ride my bike to school. One day, it was really windy. I was like 10 minutes late for school. So I walked into the class, and the teacher was like, "Why are you late?" And I was like, "Oh, it was windy." She just goes, "Get out." And all the class just laughed at me.
Did you get laughed at a lot as a kid?
Let's leave that, right? To find out more about aerodynamics and why I was late for school, we've brought on someone who is clearly never late for school, Lisa, who's an aerospace engineer. Thanks for coming.
Thanks for having me.
Hello. Were you ever late for school?
Oh, no, definitely not.
Definitely not. I'd love to get your opinion on some of the aerodynamics of Dan and I, so why don't we go over to the screen
and have
a little look. Okay, first clip.
The idea behind that was, I was trying to sit down fully 90 degrees with my legs, but I couldn't do it unless I had that little bit extra where I put my hands out to help me.
Makes sense.
Get a bit
yeah,
more.
Just a little more drag.
It was amazing the difference that this made.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Over here, what I'm doing is I was holding my lab coat out and I was trying to make forward progress. And the more I had it open, I actually couldn't go anywhere.
Like, oh,
it was,
that makes like, sense. You've got a parachute behind you at that point. So this is a great example of the four forces acting on you all at once. You're trying to exert thrust on yourself by moving yourself forward. You've got the drag of the wind pushing on you, trying to keep you back. You've got the weight of your body keeping you on the floor. And then the lift, you can actually see a little bit in the parachute from your lab coat and just that kind of lift and pushing up on your chest as you lean forward too. So all of those forces are acting on you at once, even as the wind is blowing in one direction.
I look like I'm totally chilling there.
You're on the top of your life.
Usually it's so much effort to do that, but it was so easy because of the wind. I mean, now that it takes 80 miles an hour to do that for me.
And now I've gone for a jump here. By me jumping forwards, I went almost straight up and came back down like this.
Wow. You'd be so late for school.
Yeah. If I had a lab coat on and I was walking through that to school, I wouldn't get there.
Yeah.
Couldn't make it.
This was actually the scariest thing that I did. I was wondering what would happen if I went on the floor, but as soon as I held up my lab coat like a parachute, it just started sucking me along the floor. And I got some significant distance here. See, here's me, I've got like, I'm going too fast, so I've put it down, and I'm still, the momentum is still.
is still across the screen. Apologies for that. No one wants to see that. So why don't we move on to a little tabletop experiment? So we've been to a multi-million pound wind tunnel in England, and now for our tabletop experiment, we've got a little wind tunnel that didn't cost millions of pounds.
Multi-pounds.
Multi-pounds, though.
Yeah.
Can't get it for a quid. It's just a normal fan with a tube, bunch of tape, and a lovely clear wind tunnel area. So we can test out these two cars. We've got an old boxy one and a lovely streamlined one.
Because we can't see air, so we won't know what's going to happen, we've got this vaporizer here, which is going to create a bit of smoke for us. I'm going to shove it in, and hopefully we'll see the smoke going around the cars in different patterns.
Why don't we start with the boxy one?
What is your prediction for this then?
I'm not thinking it's very aerodynamic. You're probably just gonna see smoke going everywhere.
Yeah, you can see it just bashing against the windscreen there.
Yeah, that blunt front is not doing it any favors.
Shall we try the second one?
Yeah.
A little bit bigger. But we'll pretend it's the exact same size.
All right, I'll give it some action.
So for this one, you can actually see the smoke rising over the top.
Yeah, it's coming all the way back here, and then it's coming down at the end.
Exactly. This car is much better designed for fuel economy than the old car. In this way, you save drag. And when you save drag, you save gas. And when you save gas, you save money.
What's the weirdest stuff you put in a wind tunnel?
Some of the oddest things I've seen would have to be a trash can.
Why would you need a trash can to be?
Is it to stop them blowing away in the
exactly.
wind?
Exactly. You don't want it rolling down sense. Once you've put it on the street.
Actually, I've got something I want to put in it. Thinking about it, hang on. Us.
Oh, us from episode one.
Yeah. Obviously, I assume I'm gonna be less aerodynamic. Let's put me slightly there and you slightly off.
Okay. Oh yeah, it's curling around you, it's going through your armholes.
It just goes like nothing through you. It just completely avoids you.
Do you learn the same information from doing it scaled down than you do full size?
You can learn most of the information you need from a scaled test. Usually it's a much bigger scale than this, but you definitely can.
I like that. I like it when just like physics and principles just scale up perfectly. And thank you very much, Lisa, for joining us
and
teaching us
it.
About aerodynamics. Well, hopefully you enjoyed that video. Feel free to watch other episodes from Planet Slow-Mo. Make sure you check out Dan's condom sailing. That was amazing.
Worth it. That was
and
fun.
You can subscribe to the Slow-Mo guys if you'd like. It would make us a bit happier, wouldn't it? Mm-hmm. Bit of a smile.
Not quite as happy as when I was using the condom as a
well, obviously
that was up there.